Hello, my name is Teresa Topolski. I'm the daughter of the artist Feliks Topolski. I've been asked to say a few words about him. He was Polish. He was born in Warsaw in 1907 and died here in London in 1989. And from a very early age, 7 years old, he was sketching. He was never without a sketchbook, so he knew what he was going to do with his life. So after traveling to Europe in the 1930s, he was in Paris in the 1930s, he arrived in England in 1935, and he loved England. He found it very exotic. Everybody had a costume, from the dustman to the prince to the pauper to the pearly queen. So he decided to stay. And then the war broke out, and he was an official war artist, both for the British government and for the Polish government in exile. So he was on all fronts in the war. He was on the first Arctic convoy to Russia in 1941. He was in Africa. He was in the Middle East. He was in Burma. He was everywhere. And he sent his on-the-spot drawings back to be printed up in picture posts. So people saw the war very much through Felix's eyes. Then, when the war ended, he was part of the Festival of Britain on the South Bank. The Festival Hall and the arches underneath the Hungerford Bridge became his home. So he had an arch on the Hungerford Bridge. And it was from there that he started Topolski's Chronicle, which was eyewitnessed accounts of what he saw throughout his life, a lot of which hand-printed are here in the exhibition. The Chronicle went, he did it for 18 years. It was printed very near the studio with the help of the Bernarczyks, Krystyna and Czesław Bernarczyk, hand-printed, 2,000 subscribers all over the world, and he also sold it from his studio, Open Day Studios. And it went on for 18 years, and meanwhile, he was traveling the world on commissions. He did books, films, and then in his 60s, he decided to pull it all together and make his Memoir of the Century, which was a 600-foot mural of his life and of the century underneath two arches in Hungerford Bridge. Some of it is still there under the rubric of Bar Topolski. We are still there at Topolski Studio, and we continue his Topolski's Chronicle because every year we have a residency. We're on our sixth year now, where we gather students, six students, and they travel all over England on a theme, sketching a la Topolski, eyewitnessed, and then they print it up as a chronicle, which some of the chronicles you'll see here, on an old printing press, rather like Felix did. So under the aegis of Laura Fitton, our education and outreach officer. Now, as I said, he was never without his sketchbook. So whether he was in the theatre sketching on the front row as the performance went on, or I was driving him along in the car and he'd say, could you slow down a tad? And he'd be drawing the scene as we drove along, and he'd be editing in his head as he went along, practically mostly looking, very seldom looking even down at his sketchbook. So I don't know how he did it from there to there, but only he could do it. Now, as I said, he was never without a sketchbook, and his last days were spent doing tests at St. Thomas's Hospital, which was opposite the Houses of Parliament. Now, when he got there, he said, oh, I think while I'm here, I'll sketch the Houses of Parliament again. I haven't done it for ages. Now, you'll see in this exhibition the first time he did it, reprinted in the Chronicle, which was the state funeral of Sir Winston Churchill. So he was going to sketch them again after this big gap. Unfortunately, he didn't, because he died that night. So he did end up, as he said, the artist's work will only end when he falls off his perch.